back at the worship together. All right, everyone, we're gonna, and then we have a good news. 2 days ago, Haley, can you stand up? Haley now has a new baby brother. Yay, congratulations. How do you feel, Haley? Did you see the baby? Yeah,
very good.
Is it good? Is it sleeping? Eating well? Very good. All right, Daniel. Cute. Yeah, baby brother coming very soon, right? He's not born yet.
I have a baby
sister. He's born? When?
He was born in March
12th. 정말? Oh, congrats, Daniel, stand up. Congratulations, Daniel. Is there a baby brother? Congrats, you're a big brother now. Okay. Somebody pulled your hair? Oh, okay. Do you want to take it off? Okay. All right. Put your hand down. Time to pray. Next time. Can you be patient? Close your eyes. Hands together. Bow down your head. And let's talk to God. Say, Dear God, thank you for today.
Thank you for Jesus,
who died for us.
And came back to life.
Thank you that we can be
your child
in your forever family.
Help us to listen.
Help us to obey.
We pray this
in Jesus'
name.
Amen. Good job, everyone. Let's go over some of the rules. Open up your eyes. Time to look up. And you guys are doing a good job sitting up. Sit up nicely. Yes, scoot back to the chair. Sitting up nicely. Very good. And then let's turn on your ears. Left ear. Right ear. Okay, time to listen up. All right, and catch a bubble. And so you can keep zipped up, okay? Time to listen up. So you have to zip up and hand up. Only if you have questions that's related to what I'm talking. Okay, 선생님이 얘기하는 거에 관련된 것만 손들고 얘기하는 거예요. 왜냐면은 우리가 시간이 많이 있지 않아서 we don't have all the time today. So we have to, maybe you can save those questions or comments to later when we have time together. All right, Kira? Do you understand? Is it something related to what I'm talking that you want to share? Okay, Kira. Right, very good. Jesus died for our sins. We're going to learn more about why and how we can live as God's child, okay? All right, guys. So, we're going to go over some of the stories that we learned. So, Jesus, even though he didn't do anything wrong, people who didn't believe Jesus was the Son of God put him on a cross, right? And he was on the cross, crucified with the nails, and he was put between the criminals of two crosses of the two criminals, right? Yeah. And, yeah, people have been crying. It was so sad. People who love Jesus, women and the men, the followers of Jesus, they were so sad because they nailed Jesus who didn't do anything wrong on a cross. And then after that, a person whose name was Joseph of Arimathea, he came to the Roman officer and asked for Jesus' dead body. So he can go bury Jesus' body, dead body in the tomb. So he took Jesus' body and he put him in the cave that he owned. And then back those days, when people die, they put the dead body in the cave, big cave. And then they put a big stone so nobody could take the body away, right? And then remember the bad people, mean people who didn't believe in Jesus, but they remember Jesus claiming that he's going to come back to life. So they were afraid. What if these people just steal Jesus' body and claim that Jesus has risen? So that to make sure nobody steal his body, they put a... Yeah, so they put these Roman soldiers in front of this big tomb so nobody would come and steal Jesus' dead body. They made sure There are like four squads day and night, so nobody will come at night or in the morning. But then, while they were still guarding the big tomb, there was a big earthquake. And then an angel came down from heaven, and this angel rolled the stone away, the door away. It was so big and so heavy. Yeah, it was so heavy, but who is the creator of this stone? Who made the stone? 예나. 예수님, 예수님이 돌을 만드셨기 때문에, and angels are sent by Jesus, God, sent by God, so he was, those angels could roll the stone away. And then, this is the angel. Angel, and then he sat on the stone. And these soldiers, they were terrified because there was a big earthquake, and these angels rolled the stone away. They were so terrified, they all ran away. They all ran away, and early in the morning, very early in the morning, those followers of Jesus, one of the girls, female's name was Mary Magdalene. She came to the tomb bringing the herbs, spices, to put around Jesus' dead body. Because she remembered Jesus was sitting there. I should go and just put these spices around Jesus' dead body to remember him. But then when she came, she was so surprised. The stone was rolled away. Jesus was not in there. So she was crying, and she went to Jesus' disciples. Do you guys remember the name of the disciples of Jesus? 예수님이 제일 사랑하셨던 두 제자, Peter and John한테 가서, she ran to Peter and John and said, Jesus, the stone is rolled away, and Jesus' body is not in there. And then she shared their news, but they couldn't believe it, right? So they ran to the tomb and checked the place, and it was right. Jesus' dead body is not there. The stone was rolled away, and the soldiers were not here. And then these John and Peter, they went back to where they were, but they didn't know. They couldn't believe, they didn't know what was going on. But then Jesus appeared, but he didn't say, when Jesus appeared here, Mary Magdalene didn't recognize this was Jesus. She thought he was a gardener, and she asked him, "Sir, if you are the one who took away Jesus' body, please let me know." But then this person whom Mary didn't recognize, all of a sudden said, "Mary." At that time, Mary recognized he was a risen Jesus. That was amazing, right? And then so Mary ran to disciples' home to tell Jesus' reason, "I saw Jesus," but those disciples didn't believe Mary's words. But then Jesus appeared. Let's go back to our lesson. And then here, they didn't believe, but then the disciples were inside the house, and then door was locked. But all of a sudden, this risen Jesus with resurrected body, he just went through the door, and then he showed them the nail mark, the open nail mark on his hand, and he ate with him so they could believe. That's amazing. So Jesus told, "Why are you guys so afraid? I told you I'm going to have to die, and then I'm going to rise on the third day. Here I am." And then he spent time with his disciples. So let's go ahead and watch a video, short clips of what we are learning.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus goes to heaven. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Jesus is the Savior of the world and the Son of God. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles, like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
But some people did not like what Jesus was doing, and they put him to death. He died on a cross and was buried in a tomb. For 3 days, Jesus' body laid in that tomb, and it seemed that there was no hope. But Very early on Sunday morning, the woman who cared for Jesus went to go visit his body, found that his tomb was empty and that he was no longer there. For he was risen. He was alive.
Woohoo!
And then for the next 40 days, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others and showed them that he was alive and well. He taught them that what he did was the only way that they could be forgiven and be with God forever. Jesus told his disciples that he did all the things that God had told everyone that he would do, and the disciples understood what he was saying.
Yep, that makes sense.
He told them that he would send the Holy Spirit, just as God had promised to be their helper.
Sounds good.
After Jesus had spent 40 days with the disciples and appeared to many people, he led the disciples to a place called Bethany. Jesus blessed the disciples and told them to go out and tell the whole world about him and the good news of forgiveness and make disciples of them. Then he said, "Be sure of this. I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Then Jesus was taken into heaven to sit at the right hand of God. Not long after that, the Holy Spirit did come to the disciples to be their helper. The disciples knew that God would truly be with them always, and the Holy Spirit is still with us today. For Jesus promised that he would be with us to the end of the age, and he is.
Yeah, just like that, Jesus, after he resurrected from death, he, with his risen body, he stayed on the earth for 40 more days. 40일 동안 예수님께서 다시 죽으셨다가 부활하신 다음에 40일 동안 친구들이랑 sit down, zip up, put your hand down, time to listen. Okay, question related to this? Okay. Yeah, that's why we're learning. Yeah, Jesus taking away our sin, but Jesus wants us to learn how to live as God's child. Put your hand down. All right, so Jesus was teaching a lot of things, and Jesus says, "Oh, I'm about to go up to heaven, but don't worry. Don't worry, because somebody is going to come down and will help you live as a child." And Jesus, as with his resurrected body, he talked with them, he ate with them, and they could touch Jesus, they could do everything. Jesus wanted everyone to believe Jesus really died and came back to life, right? Yeah, and those people who are living back then, they could see, right? They could see Jesus died and came back to life. But do you think we can still believe in Jesus even though it's 2,000 years after this happened? We can still believe it because the Bible says so, right? So let's all stand up and sing this song. We could, even though we cannot see him, we can still believe it.
I could not be there to see Jesus die, but I can know God and understand why. I may not be big or tall or so wise, but I can know God made Jesus alive.
What Jesus has done, Jesus died on the cross and he come back to life. That's why we can have, you can be a child in his forever family, because the Bible says we are all born with wanting to do and go our own way. When you don't want to share your toy with your friends, or when you have to take care of your sister or brother but you don't do it, you tease him, maybe you pinch him, you kick him, If you do that, the naughty things that we do, and like not obeying your parents, and lying and cheating. Yeah, so those things, those naughty things that we do, because we are all born with this nature, that's called a sin, right? Yeah, we are all like that, because the Bible says we are all like that. We are born with this sinful nature, right? So the punishment for sin is death. That means you have got to be separate from the perfect God, because God is perfect and just. He cannot just go ahead and say, oh, it's okay, I love you. You can just be my child. Can never do that because he's perfect. He has to punish the sins. And the sin is to be separate from God forever. But God doesn't want that to happen. So his only solution was to send Jesus, who is perfect, Son of God, who didn't ever, ever sin, to come to the world, born as a baby, and then we know the memory verse, right?
I never do that.
You never do that? But that's not right because the Bible says everyone is a sinner. So if you think that you're not doing that, maybe you have to think again. All right, so let's go ahead and open up our Bible and recite this Bible. Put your hand down. Ready? Go. 1 Corinthians 15, 3, 4, 5. Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, was buried, raised on the third day according to the scriptures, and he was seen by many people for 40 days, right? All right, that's the reason we can believe in and then become a child of God in his forever family. And do you remember what Jesus said? Even though I'm going back to heaven, you guys not gonna see me any longer, but don't worry, Holy Spirit, do you guys remember who Holy Spirit is? Holy Spirit is a third person of God. He's just about the same as God. God the Son, Jesus, they are the three in one God. So Holy Spirit is going to come down, and he's going to help you to live as God's child, right? So let's all stand up and sing this song. Size. While they were, after 40 days, Jesus has spent 40 days with his people, all of a sudden, when everyone's looking, all the people who were with Jesus that day was looking, he suddenly went up to heaven. He went to heaven through the clouds. What do you think they might have felt? The Bible says they kept looking and looking until he was gone. And then the Bible says here, when they kept looking at the, gazing at the sky to see where Jesus had gone, disappeared, two angels came down and said, people, this Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. So you guys, Jesus has taken up to heaven, but he's going to come back the same way from the clouds. That's what these angels said. And we know that is true because it's in the Bible. Everything that is written in the Bible is completely true. The Bible is God's word. It's called Scripture, Bible, Holy Scripture, 성경책. Everything that's in the Bible is true. And I just read that from the Bible, and it's true. We don't know when Jesus is going to come back, but we know for sure he's going to come back the same way he was taken up to heaven, right? So how does Jesus want us to live? And where is Jesus right now? Where is Jesus right now? Yena. Yeah. Yeah. He's up in the clouds somewhere in heaven. And heaven is God's home. Because Jesus is a creator of everything. He is in charge of the heaven and also the earth. And then this Jesus. Yeah. This Jesus. Zip up, guys. Time to zip up. Shh. Shh. Zip up. Catch a bubble. Catch a bubble, everyone. So this Jesus who's in heaven, he's in charge of everything, and he loves you, and he's the one who created you. He loves you just the way he created you. He loves you just the way he made you, right? And this Jesus wants you, and then the Bible says Jesus is taking care of you, all right? Jesus is watching over you. The Bible says Jesus never goes to sleep, or he just falls into sleep. He's never tired. He's taking care of you, right? And what is in heaven?
Yeah,
We know that someday God is going to come back, Jesus is going to come back, and then people who believe in Jesus and who live as God's child will be going to heaven and living in heaven with God. So the Bible says, so heaven, there are lots of things. Some of the things in heaven are
really,
yeah, like streets of gold, cities that's made with gold, lots of jewelries, something like that, sparkling, shiny, and it has streets of gold, so shiny, people will just go there, and there is a tree of life, and these tree of life has lots of leaves, it's going to be a medicine that can heal everyone, and there's angels, and then they always praise God, but in heaven, there are some things that's not in heaven. Can you guys guess what's that? There's no criminals, because only who believe in Jesus and who was forgiven can go to heaven, right? Something else that doesn't belong to heaven? Daniel? Rainbow? I'm not sure. Maybe something beautiful might be there. Kira? Yeah. Yeah, so there's no sickness, so no sadness. You don't have to cry over there because your mom is gone. My mom didn't pick me up early today. I'm so sad. You don't have to cry because it's perfect place in heaven. So who can get into heaven? The Bible says Jesus, God knows who is going to go to heaven. It's all written in his book of life. So anyone who believes in Jesus as their Savior, who believes that Jesus died for them and came back to life, and anyone who lives as God's child. So how can you live as God's child?
I got something for Jesus.
Yeah. So like when the Bible says obey your parents, what do you have to do? To live as God's child. Even though it's hard sometimes to obey your parents, the Bible says the Holy Spirit lives in you and helps you to live the right way. So the Bible says obey your parents and you have to obey your parents. And what are some of the things that you can do to live as God's child? 어떻게 하면 하나님의 child으로 살 수 있어요, Daniel? Yeah, I already told that. But something else. Yes, Kira. Yeah, you have to believe. And what about those people who didn't know? Who doesn't know about this good news? Yes, Ayo. Huh? Yeah, you have to tell them about it. That's the last thing that Jesus said before he was taken up to heaven. We have to bring this good news to the people, your friends who don't know about Jesus. So I have this little Bible fold up. I'm going to give it to you at the Sunday school. So, yeah, this simply goes over the things that you can share with your friends. So, you're going to have time with your Sunday school teacher. It's okay. They get to learn English. And there might be some friend who can translate. All right, everyone. So, in heaven, we don't know when we're going to go to heaven. A lot of people, mostly when they're old, they pass away, and that's when we go to heaven. But we don't know when to come back and just take us to heaven. But the reason we are living right now is because there's a purpose, there's a plan. And God's plan for us while we are living on this earth is growing as God's child, living as God's child, and also sharing this good news to the people who don't know Jesus. That's what we have to do, all right? Yeah, so let's all pray about that, and let's all live as God's child, all right? All right, very good. Close your eyes. Hands together, bow down your head, and let's talk to God. Say,
dear God,
thank you for sending Jesus
to give us eternal life.
Help us to learn about you more and to live as your child. Thank you. We pray this in your name.